Hi guys, this is Jason.com and I'm here with a little bundle of joy. It's called the Apple Watch Series 4. I've been playing with it for a while now, and now it's time for a full review of the device. Okay, so probably not the best idea to spend the holidays with the Apple Watch considering you're going to eat, but then again, you have to exercise. So the Apple Watch Series 4, right? The price is around $399 for the core version, $499 if you want the cellular 4G model. We have the 44 millimeter version of the device. And as you know, it got a lot of praise for the ECG thing, the EKG. And sadly, in our country, this hasn't been activated. But in US, it has been activated recently via software. Anyways, the device was announced with the three new iPhones last September, and we're here for a full review. The design involves premium metal and glass. You can see the device is clad in metal with a curved glass panel at the front that looks beautiful. It's got narrower bezels than the predecessors. We don't have the most inspired belt, but we're going to have to live with it. In order to remove the belt, you have to press this button here and then gently slide it to the side. That's how you detach it, that's how you attach it, and it's pretty intuitive and makes a satisfying click. Now at the back side here, we have a bit of ceramic going on, and you also have some special metallic elements which are used to get your pulse. The device is available in silver, sprays gray, and gold. It has two buttons. There's a crown button here which helps you with the navigation around the elements. So for example, if you have a scrollable list, you can use the crown button. You can also keep it pressed to trigger Siri. That's one example, and several more tasks. Now the other button is this one here. It's basically the power button, but can also be used for the multitasking. So this button and the crown button are the things you're going to be using for input. And of course, there's also a touch screen. Well, other than that, there's been an upgrade from the 38 millimeter and 42 millimeter to 40 and 40 millimeter sizes. The device has a premium design for sure. To be honest, it's a bit smaller in real life compared to the renders. It's also thinner than the Series 3. They dropped the thickness from 11.4 millimeters to 10.7 millimeters. Now the backside has some black ceramic going on and sapphire crystal. We also have a thinner crown button compared to the predecessor, and also some haptic feedback for the scrolling, which is satisfying. By the way, forgot to mention, it has a 5 atmosphere waterproofing, and that's nice to have. Okay, now the display itself, as you can see, is very crisp, clear, bright, excellent contrast. It has narrower bezels and a 44 millimeter panel. You can see here, well, this one offers a resolution of 448 pixels over 368 pixels. It's an OLED, of course, and the 40 millimeter version offers a 340 over 272 pixel resolution. It promises 1000 nits of brightness like the predecessor. It's great in the sunlight. We had zero problem with the contrast, excellent colors. And well, that's basically it. I'm very happy with the screen, the way it looks, the colors, the clarity, and even the amount of text it can display. So if I want to look at the message, for example, you can clearly see the things that are on the screen with zero problems. Okay, bright, comfy, and it's between 30 hertz and 60 hertz. That's nice to have on such a small screen. Now, if you want more details about the hardware, this little bundle of joy has an S4 processor, 64-bit dual core CPU, a new GPU. It also has a special wireless chip for fast Bluetooth 5.0, and a special new accelerometer up to 32 G-forces, also gyroscope, which can detect if you're falling, which is useful for the elderly, so they won't fall or have their fall detected, which is important at a certain age. There's a GPS, there's 4G LTE on the associated version, there's Galileo, QZSS, there's a barometric altimeter, yeah, there's such a thing, and a special electrical heart sensor, which I can trigger from the dedicated feature here. Let me just go to it, press it, should start measuring the heart rate, as you can see right now. So for the past minutes, I've been showing you the watch. Let's actually put it on the hand, so it would be silly not to put it on the hand in such a review. Here we go, strapping it up. Not a big fan of the strap, but you can buy multiple options, and some of them thanks to the Apple partners. This is more like it. This is how it fits on my wrist. And yes, there will be the random activation. It happened to me a bunch of times when it's going to rub against my clothes or have some hair caught in it. Anyways, let's change this. Maybe with another watch face. My favorite one has to be the flower one, but I digress. I actually digress a lot. Let's get back to what we were saying. So, optical heart sensor and the speaker, which you can see here on this side, the speaker is now 50% higher in volume. I can attest to that, especially in the calls, which, by the way, didn't impress me very much. It's a long way to go till you can actually fight a phone. But anyways, decent for a watch. We also have a microphone, which should be on this side here, if I'm not mistaken. Sorry for bumping the camera. It's here next to the crown button. And other than that, an ambient light sensor, 16 gigabytes of storage from what I know. There's Wi-Fi BGN. Also, there's a battery, lithium-ion battery, which is supposed to offer up to 18 hours of usage. Basically, you should get around the same usage time as the predecessor. Now, the case is made of stainless steel or aluminum, depending on what you want. Now, there are many features to show you here, so let's talk about calls first. You can take phone calls on the device. You can handle those. You got your favorites, recent, contact, keypad, start a call from the watch if you want. And you can hook it up to your phone, make them interact together as one. But once again, you have the 4G cellular version. You probably can take calls for itself. Once again, the volume was satisfying, but the clarity not the best in the world. It sounds like an older phone. The microphone still was pretty decent. Now, on the battery front, I actually got to about 2 or 3 days of usage on my holiday with a single charge, which is pretty impressive for me. But I guess I'm not a power user, so there's that. Okay, so let's talk about the interface. As you can see, I'm moving around this cloud of apps. Apple has basically patented this. There's a cloud, you can call it a honeycomb, you can call it whatever you want, and you can use the crown button to go into an app or exit it by rotating it. Press the crown app and you'll be returned to the main watch face, which you can tweak. Press it again, you'll go to the app area. You also have the power button, which you can press once to summon your multitasking, and if you want to close something, you do this with an X, pretty straightforward. In the main area, you swipe down to see notifications, I guess. Swipe up to see useful stuff like a control center. There's your Wi-Fi, there's the airplane mode, there's vibration, do not disturb, and a walkie-talkie mode. You can also do walkie-talkie with other iPhones. Now, the watch faces are very cool. I actually spent something like 1 hour messing with them. You got your time lapse, and some of them will actually be alternated. I found one which was incredible. There was the Earth or the Moon, and it switched phases as I was rotating the button, the crown button. So, well, guess what? Can't find it right now. There's a lot of them. You can also switch them from the phone. Once again, using the crown button to find the ideal one. I could also make a flower bloom by rotating that button. Numerals, motion, Mickey Mouse, chronograph, breed, astronomy, that's it. This is the one I love the most, and you can see the moon phases, which is pretty cool. Now, hopefully I can also get the Earth one. Let's go back. Okay, and customize. This is the Earth one. I love this, it's totally the best. Here we go, check this out. So I can see the Earth as the hours pass and the cities are getting lit up. And that, in my book, is a superb work of art. Now, I talked before about customization. Now, if you pick a more complex one, like the infograph, you can customize multiple aspects of it. You can customize the corners, the center area. And once again, you'll do the scrolling like this, date, friends, mail, messages, moon, phone, what have you, in all of these parts. So lots of stuff to tweak in order to properly organize your info. Now, you can also do other things on this device. Obviously, you can listen to music, and you can also listen to podcasts. There's such a thing. You can have them on the iPhone or straight on the watch. You have here your radio section, and you can even control the camera of the phone remotely. Press this, and now I can see whatever the camera is showing. You can see me right here, and I can also see myself on the watch, basically, which is pretty cool. And some people may feel the need to creep with that and be stalkers, but let's leave that for another video. Okay, other features. So I showed you the camera, there's the music player, there's this home feature to control your smart stuff around the house. You can find friends, you can obviously check out the weather, which is no-brainer. You can see the Apple stocks, the calendar, take or make calls. You have the fitness section, which can be nifty synchronized to your Apple Health. This is one of the most important apps. You have to breathe, relax every once in a while so you won't get stressed. Very important, and you can actually schedule it. And you can see the heart rate dropping, so it's actually useful. Walkie-talkie, talk to your friends without their Apple Watches. And remember that you can send your heartbeat as a message, which is a pretty cool feature once again. This is the music player. You can alternate between mixes, listen to some tunes. And this is where you're going to store your plane tickets and movie tickets. Well, that's about it. Of course, there's the fitness aspect. You go here, got your activities. You got indoor stuff. The indoor stuff and the outdoor stuff has been clearly separated. They've added more activities. And there's also this activity area, which organizes the things you do and takes care of stuff like how long you stand and how much you're moving. Sadly, the watch does not do sleep tracking. Apple wants to sell those sleep tracking accessories, so I kind of get them. And you also have a photo gallery somewhere which you can display on the screen in case you need that. Now, from the phone itself, these are the things. You have your watch faces here, which you can edit. You have your complications, which you can install. There's the app layout, which you can tweak from here. This is my own iPhone 7, by the way. This is the dock area with the recent and favorites. You got the general section, airplane mode, watch orientation, Apple ID, handoff. There's a lot of stuff, basically. Activity, breathe, calendar, and so forth. This is the face gallery with astronomy, breathe, many more. So you can actually tweak a lot of stuff. Original Disney ones and an app store dedicated entirely to this piece of wearable. Okay, and then you can search and let's see what else. You can even install Uber, and of course you get notifications, will feel a bit which will feel a bit as if you're being nudged. Now, if you want to do Siri, let's check this out. Who was Bill Gates?
Here is what I found.
Well, excuse me, it's actually who is Bill Gates. Don't want to be creepy. And this is a great way of finding out that he's reasonably tall, 1 meter and 77 centimeters, not bad. And another way of seeing text very niftily on the screen. Now, people will be copying in exams, but I don't want to encourage that. So anyways, Siri can tell me a lot of things. What's the weather like?
Okay, here's the weather for today.
Okay, that's about it, straight from the wrist. And I think that's all she wrote. That's all I have to say about the Apple Watch Series 4. Now, my own impression of the device. Not very happy with the whole speaker and call stuff. It sounds like a lesser phone, more like the something that could actually replace a phone. The speaker is okay, the microphone is okay, but not the best quality. A bit of distortion in calls. I'm happy with the fitness stuff, so I actually synced everything I did today with my own Apple Health, and you can see stuff here. This is what I did today. You can see the calories, the areas I walked, the hours, the volume of oxygen, exercise minutes, walking and running, so a lot of stuff to track. So if you're doing it for fitness, it's fine. If you're buying it for design, once again, it's fine. It's a beautiful piece of work, except for the belt, which you should get another one probably. Not very sure about the whole pulse thing. At times it feels exaggerated. 140 BPM means either I have a problem when walking, and also the oxygen meter wasn't very impressive, so may need some work in the pulse department. EKG is not activated in my country just yet. I have yet to hear about this experience from USA. In general, I was more conquered by the software and by the facade, the curved glass, than anything else. In the end, is it worth it? Well, if you're a cheapskate, you probably will stick to your affordable wearable for your fitness sessions and that's it. But if you want a phone replacement at the wrist, on the go, this is basically it. I find the interface to be light years ahead of the Android rivals. On the pro side, the design, comfiness, accuracy of health and fitness. I would also have to say that the EKG and the fall for the elderly are pluses. okay battery life, and basically a great screen. Those are the pros. On the cons, no EKG in my country just yet. Speaker is not exactly impressive. No sleep tracking, a bit pricey. No syncing with Android devices, probably never will. A bit smaller than expected. And suddenly it exits the workout every once in a while. It wants to exit it for no reason. I'd buy it because I'm in the ecosystem. I have some Apple devices. I'm used to it. And what can I say? It feels like a natural extension of my iPhone on my wrist. They should work more on the speaker, probably add some extra battery, and try not to make it exit the fitness randomly. This is from gsnl.com. Hope you enjoyed the review, and I've played with the Apple Watch Series 4 together with my very own iPhone 7. Bye bye.